Hello， 大家好，我是本次英语课的老师，大家可以叫我 Jacqueline。
Okay, let's find out what we're going to learn today.
Oh my God, shopping English. 现在双十二又快到了，估计又有一大波的剁手党要出现了。
Before we start this lesson, there are some new words and phrases we need to learn about. Let's look at number one. I'd like to see something. Equals, I would like to see something.
表示意愿，我想看看某物。或者某人也可以。
And number two, show me. Show me your hand. Show me your shoulder.
小学的儿歌都有唱哈，这个比较简单。
Number three, look for.
寻找。
I'm looking for someone or I'm looking for something. And number four, prefer.
更喜欢。
Which one do you prefer?
哪个你更喜欢一点呢？
I prefer the left one.
我更喜欢左边那个。
Number five, color.
这个是美式的拼写，英式的拼写呢是 C-O-L-O-U-R。 那么为了简单容易记住，我们还是使用美式的比较好一点。
Color,
颜色。
Number six, size.
尺寸，大小。
This man is big. So, clothes...He's wearing must be big size.
这个人他长得很壮，那么他身上的衣服呢，必须是比较大的尺寸才能够穿得上。
Price, number seven, price.
或者在外贸英语里面，有一些客人的询价，他们会说 What's the pricing? Pricing and price 是一样的。
And the next one is bottom price or cost price.
意思差不多，就是当我问你这个价钱是多少的时候，店主就会说，哎呀，这个是最低价了，成本价了，我都不赚了，就这样卖给你吧。是不是这样说？
This is my bottom price. I couldn't lower the price anymore. And the next one is lower, reduce. Lower the price, reduce the price. Number 10, be out of something.
Be, it means am, is, are. 根据我们的第一人称、第二人称还是第三人称当复数的形式去使用这个 be, 到底是 am 还是 is 或者是 are.
We are running out of time.
我们时间不够了，现在时间很紧急，得快点。
We must be hurry. Somebody is out of something.
某人缺少某物，或者这个店里面的某物已经卖光了，没有了，销量很好。
And the next one, number 11, blouse. Blouse,
宽松的上衣，类似衬衫的比较宽松的上衣。这个女生们应该比较懂一点，或者我们可以直接 copy 宽松的上衣上淘宝上看一下到底是什么样的。
And the next one, number 12, skirt,
半身裙。我们平常说的连衣裙是 dress.
And the dress also mean put on something.
Dress, 两个词性，一个是名词，一个是动词。做动词用的话就是穿上，穿的怎样。OK, 题外话不讲那么多。好。
Number 13, sleeve,
袖子。
Sleeve,
V-E-V, 正音 sleeve.
And number 14, tie,
领带，就是粤语讲的领带。
Okay, conversation one.
Conversation one, 这里是会比较长一点。我们先来看一下它的英文原文，看一下我们到底懂了多少，然后再一句一句的来分析，好吗？
OK。
哦，好长啊。不用怕，我们慢慢来。 Clerk 就是销售员、导购员的意思，收银员也有这个意思。那个收银员他就说 May I help you, ma'am? Anna 就是进来购物的顾客。
Yes, thank youI'm looking for a blouse.
Our blouses are on the left, and please have a look. I think this one is okay.
Oh, what color do you prefer?
I need something to go with my brown skirt.
Here's a pretty green one, but it has long sleeves.
I'd like a short-sleeved blouse with a high neck. If you have one.
We have this one in yellow. What size do you take?
34. Do you have that one in my size?
Yes, here it is.
How much is it?
It costs £8.
Oh my, that's too expensive for me. Do you have anything like this for less?
I'm afraid not.
Well, I think I'll look around some more, but I may come back for this one. Thank you.
You're welcome. 啊，情景演绎好累啊。好，我们来看一下中文。Clerk, 他说 May I help you, ma'am? 尊敬的女士，请问有什么可以帮您呢？
Yes, thank you. I'm looking for a blouse.
是的，西线，我在找宽松的上衣。
Our blouses are on the left. On the left side. And please have a look.
我们的衬衣在左侧，请看。
I think this one is okay.
这件还 OK.
What color do you prefer?
你喜欢什么颜色呢?
I need something to go with my brown skirt.
我需要和我的棕色裙子搭配的颜色。
Here's a pretty green one.
我们有这种漂亮的绿色。好，翻译完了，看一下我们要掌握的短语，还有一些固定搭配。
May I help you?
这个无论是在购物或者住酒店或者是餐厅里面的那些服务员，他肯定第一句话就会说 Hello, may I help you? What can I do for you?
Ma'am
是对女士的尊称，尊敬的女士的意思。
And Anna said, Yes, thank you. I'm looking for a blouse.
她在找宽松的上衣。 Be looking for something. Look for something.同样的，这个 be 我们要根据它是第一人称、第二人称还是第三人称，单数或者复数形式去区分它到底用的是 am, is 或者是 are， 好不好 ？OK。
The next sentence. Our blouses are on the left side, and please have a look.
我们的衬衣在左边
，on the left, on the left side
都一样。
And please have a look.
请看 ，have a look.
I think this one is okay.
What color do you prefer?
What color do you prefer?
Which one do you prefer?
What size do you prefer?
句型，但是这个要记住。
What color? What size? What
do you prefer? Okay, next one.
I need something to go with my brown skirt.
我需要和我棕色短裙搭配的那种颜色。
Need something to go with.
这里的 to go with my brown skirt 就是与我的短裙搭配了。
To go with.
With 这个介词很好用，大家可以去查一下 with 很多的一些例句。
Here's a pretty green one. Okay, let's come to the next page. But it has long sleeves. I'd like a short-sleeved blouse with...A high neck, if you have one.
这个袖子太长了，这件衣服，我们用 it 来代称。It 这件衣服 has long sleeves. 我很嫌弃它袖子太长了，我喜欢短一点的。还有，它不仅要袖子要短，它还要高领的。你可以这样讲
：I'd like a short-sleeved blouse.
短袖 short sleeve blouse.衬衣
，with a high neck。
你要形容一件物品，你不能同时用太多形容词的时候，你可以用一个 with 后面再加这个物品的特征。High neck， 它必须是高领的。
We have this one in yellow. What size do you take?
In yellow. This little girl in yellow over there is my sister.那边穿黄色衣服的小女孩是我的妹妹。
Somebody in yellow, something in yellow.
就是具体我看到那个人那个物是这种黄色，我指代这个人，特指这个人，我告诉你啊，他是我的谁啊，或者是这个东西是我的，就是一种表特征。In yellow， 我要讲这个东西什么颜色的时候，就可以说 something in yellow is， 嘟嘟嘟 ，34， 这是欧美的 size。Do you have that one in my size？ In my size， 我的尺寸。Yes， here it is， 给你。How much is it？ How much？ 你可以简单一点说 How much？ 多少钱 ？How much is it？How much are they? 复数 How much are they? 或者 How much is it? 而且可以直接说 How much? 多少钱的意思 It costs 8 pounds. Cost 名词有成本的意思，动词呢就是花了多少钱，花了多长时间。 It costs 8 pounds. Pounds 英镑 Dollars 美金。Oh my, that's too expensive for me. Do you have anything like it for less? Oh, 我的天啊，对于我来说太贵了。Expensive for me, 对于我来说太贵了。For me, 对我来说。Do you have anything like it? 你有其他同款的或者类似的衣服 ？For less, 省略了 less。Price, less cost, 便宜一点的 less. Do you have anything like it for less? 你有同款但是便宜一点的宽松上衣吗？ Oh, I'm afraid not. 这句话又出现了，高频率语句。Be afraid, I am afraid not. I'm afraid he's out of the office. 熟悉吗？电话英语里面的。I'm afraid, he's not here.I'm afraid we don't have these trousers. We don't have. I'm afraid we don't have this. What blouses? Right. And Anna said, "Well, I think I'll look around some more, but I may come back for this one. Thank you." 她又说，我在周围逛一下吧。可是我还会有可能回来买这件的。谢谢你啊。You're welcome.After a while, 这个是我自己家的情节哈。After a while, Anna came back to the shop and said, "Okay, I'll take one." 我就要这个一件。I'll take it. I'll take this blouse for one. I'll take it. 我就要这件了。现在我们来总结一下，一般购物的时候我们需要用到的这些语句的一些特点，好吗？第一点呢，就是刚刚那一段对话是发生在商店的服装部，很容易看出来他是要找那个上衣。当看到顾客的时候，店员一般都会主动迎上去，热情地为顾客提供讲解跟服务。一般他们首先会说 May I help you? 或者 What can I do for you? 对话中的 ma'am 就是对女士礼貌的称呼，这刚刚提到了。第二点 ,blouse 是宽松的上衣，就是跟衬衫很类似的那种上衣。I need something to go with the brown skirt. 我想要买一件上衣配我的棕色裙子。刚刚这个也提到了，对吧 ？Go with 这里是与什么什么搭配的意思。And number three， 当我们向别人询问穿多大码或者什么 size 的衣服或者鞋子的时候，可以说 What size do you take? What size do you take? 当顾客得知那件上衣要八英镑的时候，觉得太贵了，于是他就会说 Do you have anything like it for less? 对，在这里。你们有没有像这种款式但是便宜一点的呢？表示用多少钱买某东西的时候，要用介词 for less。比如 I bought my new car.For 20,000, I bought my new car for 20,000. 第四点， 最后，这个顾客决定再到其他地方看看的时候，他说 "look around some more" 是口语中比较简便的说法，我们可以理解为 "look around for some more blouses"。虽然顾客没有一开始没有买到这件商品，但是店员还是会很礼貌的跟他说 "You're welcome"。OK， 我们继续来看一下改编后的情景对话二。May I help you, ma'am?
Yes, thank you. I'm looking for a blouse.
Sorry, we haven't.
End of the story.
然后这单买卖就黄了，因为他根本就没有这种衣服卖。你好，请问有什么可以帮您？好的，谢谢。我在找宽松的上衣。对不起，我们没有。
What a pity. Let's go on. Conversation 3.
情景对话三。May I help you, ma'am?
Yes, thank you. I'm looking for a blouse.
Our blouses are on the left, and please have a look.
I think this one is okay. Can I try?
Try it.
And where is the fitting room?
Sorry, it is on sale, so it cannot be tried.
On sale.
猜不猜到？
On sale.
我们在一般，在大商场特卖的时候都会看到 on sale 或者 special for special， 就是特价，特价的意思。后面这个我们来看一下，前面这个是都是重复的了。我想这件还 OK， 我可以试一下吗？ Can I try it? Can I try it? 或者 Can I try it on?
And where is the fitting room?
试衣间在哪儿？
Fitting room
试衣间，不好意思，我想到了优衣库。然后他就说 ，Sorry, it is on sale。这里的 it 指代的是那件衣服，这个是特价品 ，it is on sale。So it cannot be tried， 不能试穿。Okay, conversation 2. May I help you, ma'am?
Yes, thank you. I'm looking for a blouse.
Our blouses are on the left, and please have a look.
I think this one is okay. Can I try it on? Or where is the fitting room?
Yes, of course you can. The fitting room is on your left.
Oh, 他试穿完就出来，他就跟他说 It doesn't fit me. It is too tight. Do you have a bigger size?
猜到了吗？
Doesn't fit me.
我们在之前的课里面有讲到 fit suitable
or suit somebody，
这里的 suit 就是跟 fit 是一个意思，它不适合我。
It doesn't fit me. It doesn't suit me. It is too tight.
太紧了，宽松的上衣还紧啊，你到底要穿多少码？
Do you have a bigger size?
你有更大的尺寸吗？
Do you have a bigger color? Do you have a different color?
一样的，可以这样套进去用。你好，请问有什么帮您？嘟嘟嘟嘟嘟，这件还 OK， 我可以试一下吗？哦，这件不合身，太紧了。你有大一码吗？
Okay, end of the conversation 4.
Thank you for your time. Have a nice day. 别逗了，我们还没有总结呢。好，看回去。这里，我又要开始长篇大论了。还是要讲一下从文章里面学习的这种学习方法。有学习方法，有求知欲，那么就可以造成终身学习者。这个是21世纪人才的必备的技能，对不对？那么我们还是 focus on conversation 1。我的建议就是类似这种不会太长又不会太短的文章背吧。对话都是从背开始，背完了就成为了自己的语句，那么到时候你的词汇量跟句式丰富了，你就可以随意挑两句话出来。 因为不可能你去买东西的时候你要背文章那样子，还要按顺序下来，哦，我要挑什么东西，我要哪个颜色，哦，对了，颜色后面才是尺寸，我不能把尺寸放到颜色上面讲，不是这样的，是吧？你记完了之后就可以终身受用。另外后面的这一些情景对话的话，哎呦，我觉得他们好不会做生意哦。好了，题外话不讲那么多。看一下 conversation one.
May I help you?
服务员肯定要讲这个 May I help you? 无论是在餐饮，卖东西，或者是在酒店，肯定要讲这个，所以这个肯定要懂吧？对。I'm looking for something. I'm looking for someone. 警察一般都会拿着一个照片 I'm looking for John Connor. Have you seen her? Have you seen him?终结者里面的男主角。Our blouses are on the left. 介词 on the left, on the right. 这里介词 on the left. Please have a look. 哪个还 OK? 还行。This one is OK. What color do you prefer? Which one do you prefer? 这是个句型，记一下。I need something to go with my brown skirt.Go with, 与我的后面 with, 后面跟的这个 brown skirt, 搭配的颜色。Here's a pretty green one. It has long sleeves. 这件衣服它的袖子太长。Have, 它有长袖子是不是？那么我们中文翻译过来的时候就是说它袖子长。In yellow, somebody something in yellow. 黄色的某人某物。What size do you take? What size do you take? 你穿什么码呢? How much is it? How much? 多少钱? How much are they? 复数形式表达。It cost 8 pounds. 句型。拿笔拿纸记住啦。我这里上面 PPT 上面没有啊。做听力，快点。It cost somebody plus 加号 plus 加钱或者时间 to do something. It cost somebody 加钱或者时间 to do something. It cost me 1 hour to go from.My office to the shopping center. 我要花一个小时的时间从我的办公室去购物中心。It costs me 30 minutes to find you. Where were you? 花了我半个小时才能找到你。你刚刚去哪里了？女朋友的控诉。Okay, the next point. Be expensive for somebody. For somebody. 对于某人来说。I'm afraid not. 我恐怕没有了。I'm afraid not. 我恐怕不这么认为。Okay, 我们来看一下 Conversation 3里面的 Be on sale.Something be on sale. 某物是特价品。我不合适。我穿不上。It doesn't fit me. 我穿起来不合适。它不合适我。Do you have a bigger size? 你有大一码吗? Okay. This is the real one. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day.